Again, your competition is just a way of you showing everybody how well you have practiced and trained. That's all you're showing people. I worked this hard. I can do this. I'm not doing something beyond. I'm doing what I have trained myself to do. What I really want them to experience would be that you are grounded and that you stay in the moment. Grounded means is you are well balanced. You are mentally and emotionally stable. Being in the zone or the flow, it's a concentration and being absorbed totally in the task that you're doing. I mean, you're there, nothing else. The only thing you're worried about is you and your performance and how you are doing and interest level. You know, you have passion. All you do, you show that, okay? Motivation. You obviously have that. You're motivated to be the best you can be, and you want to be the best you can be for your teammates. That's critical. The third thing was confidence. What is confidence? It's a belief in yourself, right? In whatever thing that you're doing. But what we're worried about right now is our confidence in being able to perform to our highest level. Now, our highest level. There was an energy. And that set a tone, I think, in terms of the judges. I mean, everybody could feel it. Okay? And I mean, you can feel it. You could just see it and you could feel it. That passion. There's no other way, I don't think, you can have that kind of energy if you do not have passion. That for you to be really successful as an individual and as a team is you have to have all the parts. You have to have the physical, mental, and emotional. And I think you had it. On that day, you had the passion. You had the emotional part. See, those are the things that no one can take away from you, that strength that builds confidence. No one can take that away from me. I did it. My mind controlled my body, not the other way around. That creates a confidence that can't be shaken. And you know that. I'm this strong. I did not give in.
It's choosing courage over comfort. Courage comes from the Latin word cur, which is heart, translates to heart. And so it's basically showing up as yourself with your whole heart. That's what courage means. It's not about the to-do list, right? And that, I think that that's what's important, is that tomorrow we don't just go out there and check boxes, right? We show up as a team with our whole heart, ready to compete as one. And I think that that really shows how connected you truly are with each other and how much you deeply care about everybody sitting in this room. The amount of respect that you have for the team is incredible, and I think it shows. And I think that that contributes a lot to why we are doing as good as we are. You're prepared. You not only have done things outside of those practices, right, including watching huddle videos, going to extra camps, extra trainings, whatever, the things you do at your house by yourself when no one's even there. But 105 times we've been in the gym together working for this moment. You've earned where you are right now. And so I don't want you to ever doubt that, because you're prepared. If I can give you anything, it would be that confidence and that like stability and balance to know you as you are right now are enough. As you show up tomorrow, you have prepared yourself to be there. And don't have an inch of doubt about anything that you've done all season. I don't have regrets, and I'm proud of you. I truly am. And that kind of makes me want to cry. I just feel proud when they announce you on the floor and they're saying, like, dancing for you now is Becker, and I get to tell the guy to play the music and I get to watch you guys, like, give everything you have. It just feels so proud. You just have to be mentally gritty. Your body's there, you've prepared for that. And so as you move throughout your day tomorrow, constantly check in. Where am I? Am I here? Because I want you to be there. I want you to be all in it in the moment. The integrity, the grit, the values that I chose and I worked really hard at picking really show up. And it's just embedded and it's just how we do things. I think it took those 5 years for the culture to shift. And so I really like seeing that what we do is we just work hard, we train all the time, we spend time together. I really like our team culture. I think that I try to instill things that will be lifelong lessons so that when they go out into the world, they feel confident and they feel like they can make decisions and stand up for what they believe in, and that's what I want.
I've been fortunate enough to dance a lot and just to take a lot of classes, so I want to give back to these girls and help them out because I know dance can be very challenging both mentally and physically. And I also hope to inspire some of the younger girls who want to become leaders, like on the team in the future. And I absolutely love being a captain for BDT. I love being able to just be with all of the girls and like do warm-ups with them and kind of lead them at competitions. So it's very fun to hang out with them and be with them.
So that's why this season like just feels so much different, because everyone was so dedicated and so committed. And I think that's like the reason like we all feel really good on the floor together is because like we're able to give that. And I just think that state's gonna go really good for us like next week, and sections went amazing, and we just all feel very connected on the floor together. So this year has definitely been my favorite year personally, and I'm just so excited to continue on with this team.
It was really eye-opening for me. I felt like I gained like a lot of more like experiences, especially like dancing more of jazz this year. I definitely like got to experience like out of my comfort zone and really hone in on like me personally and like what was good for me at competitions and what wasn't. I see a lot of growth within the team. Like I'm super excited to watch like new girls join the team and like really see their growth. So I'm super excited about that. And I think like we're just gonna soar.
I think it's really to like not care what like people think about me. Like you're not gonna please everyone. You like just have to be yourself. Like don't do anything to please anyone. And like so I think that's something like I've learned, and like I think that'll stick with me for a long time, and that's something very valuable. After my sophomore year, like COVID year, I thought of like every moment as a gift, that we didn't know if we were gonna have a season. Like we didn't know like a bunch of things. Everything was like unpredictable. So after that especially, I like learned to just like live with like grace and treat everything as a gift. So
my first one was like literally yesterday. We played Just Dance at practice, and I wanted to do that for like so long, and it was so funny and so fun. My other favorite memory is a little more like meaningful, but after our jazz performance at Conference Champs, like just how we all felt afterwards, like it just felt so good because we were like all in, like we all knew we nailed it without even like watching it, and like feeling that from like the whole team and like feeling proud of myself too, it was like really special.
I'm just really excited to see what happens next week.
Go BDP.
I just wanted to win.
Saturday.
I'm feeling good.
Hey, let's go.